So I spend a lot of time with people who want to become nomads. Maybe they've only just begun, and people ask me all the time, how do you get started? I'm so overwhelmed, I'm afraid, what should I do for money? How do I translate my job into real income? How can I become a freelancer? And I've done videos specifically about a bunch of these things, but I thought the other day when I was speaking to someone who her and her fiance want to become nomads together, and I was giving her like my spiel of my top tips, and I thought this would be a really good video. So today's video is what I would say to you if we met up for coffee and you asked me, how on earth do I get started, Louise? And so this is going to be seven things that I would tell you if you want to become a nomad. And before I start, I wanted to say, first of all, you need to be sure that you do want to become a nomad. So have a look at my videos about the downsides, consider whether it's actually going to be the right fit for you, because it won't necessarily be super easy. It's possible for everyone, it is attainable and you can do it, and ignore if people say that you can't, because you can. But are you willing to do what it takes? Like, you could learn to surf, of course you could, but do you want to be thrown around in the sea at 7 a.m. every day in the freezing cold English Ocean? I don't know. Do you want to have to miss out on birthday parties because you have to leave early because you're getting up in the morning to drive to Cornwall? That's up to you. So you can become a nomad, absolutely, I believe that. But do you want to? Are you willing to put the work in? Different question. So let's go off with number one. So my first tip is to try and make money right away. A lot of people get really hung up on passive income and they want to start something that will make them passive income, but that won't make you money on day one. And of course, I have passive income, so I really recommend passive income. I think it is great, but I think if you start with building something that's a big long term that will make money eventually and will pay off long term, then I think either you'll run out of money and have to move back home, or you will just lose like that motivation and that hunger and that like encouragement. I think there's nothing like getting a little bit of money into your bank account to really spur you on and give you the confidence that it is possible. So that first like $5 I made on Udemy felt so good, and it made me believe this is possible. Like, oh my gosh, someone just bought my course with their money and now it's my money and this is crazy. And that really gave me so much encouragement. So I definitely think try and make money straight away and it will help you focus. Like, maybe you're starting a blog which is eventually going to sell ebooks. First of all, it's discouraging because it takes a long time to make money. Second of all, you need money to live. But third of all, you're most likely doing it wrong because it's the first thing you've ever done. So you'll be learning, which is great and is very valuable. But instead, why not just actually make some money and then do your passive income stuff on the side? Build a company on the side. And then you will learn so much more. You'll be out meeting people, being a nomad. And I think then when you do launch your kind of longer term passive income thing, that will really pay off. So yeah, my first tip is just to make some money as soon as possible, which will probably mean freelancing. So whatever you already do as a job, or whatever you're already good at, whatever your degree is in, just see if someone will pay you to do that for a few hours a week, just on a casual basis. Then number two is to decide what you want. I did a video about who counts as a digital nomad. Like, if you don't leave America, do you count? If you are living in a van, do you count? If you only move every 6 months, do you count? And spoiler alert, the answer is yes, everybody is welcome. But that video kind of explains it all in much more detail. And what I mean by this second tip of decide what you want is, do you want to have a dog, in which case you need to mostly travel by train? Or do you want to stay close to your family? Maybe you have an elderly relative and you don't want to be too far away, so in which case you need to stay in Europe, or you need to stay in America. Or do you want to, you've always wanted to see Southeast Asia, so you need to make sure you have enough money to get a flight to there, or whatever your goals are. Maybe you want to run a really big company and make $1 million, or maybe you want to just have a side thing which you enjoy and means that it gives you the flexibility to also do yoga full time. Or, what are your goals? What do you want your life to look like? Do you want to move location a lot? Or is there one area of the world that you really want to see? Do you want to be working long hours but making a lot of money, or do you want to be just earning enough to live so that you can spend your time doing fun things? And all of those, maybe to you, are quite obvious. Maybe you're like, well, of course I want to just work a little bit and have fun. But that someone else might be watching this video and being like, I want to make a lot of money and I want to live in Thailand because it's cheap so that I can invest more into my company. So there are going to be different goals for different people, and there's no point starting down a path if you don't really know what you want the end shape to look like. And your goals will change, your priorities will change, but I think it's good to at least have a direction of why are you doing this? Like, what is your why? And what do you want to get out of being a nomad? Like, what are your goals? The number three is to start a passive income as soon as possible. So I know number one was make money and don't do passive income, which I mean kind of for like week one, month one, day one, like just start making money as soon as you can. But on the side, start building a passive income, because that's ultimately the end goal, I assume, is that you don't want to always be selling your time, because at some point you're gonna have kids and you wanna take maternity leave or paternity leave, or maybe you're gonna have elderly parents who you want to look after, or maybe you're gonna wanna climb Everest. Like, there's so many different things that you could want to do with your time, and I want more for you than selling your time by the hour. So yes, start off with freelancing, make sure that you've got some money coming through the door to like take that low level anxiety of not being able to pay the bills, take that off the table. But with your spare time, start building something passive, start building something bigger, like building a company, building more income streams, building assets like investments and ebooks and courses and all these other things which are going to be like bigger than you, things that you can delegate, and things that can grow beyond just an hourly rate. And I also think with the passive income, well, actually, and by the hour, it's important to work out what suits your skills. So people quite often come to me and they say like, Louise, you've done really well on Udemy, so I want to do Udemy as well because obviously you're profitable, but I hate being on camera, and I'm no good at teaching, and I don't speak very good English, but I want to teach a course in English. And I'm kind of like, maybe you shouldn't do Udemy, maybe you should do like FBA or dropshipping or something else. There's so many other things you could do. Maybe you should do stock photography. Just the same as I wouldn't come to you and say, I really want to do stock photography, but I'm colorblind and I don't own a camera and I hate going outside and taking pictures. It's like, probably don't do stock photography. But I feel like people get really hung up on the passive income thing because of probably YouTubers like me who've said like, look how successful this is. But don't just follow the thing that you think is easy and successful. Follow the thing that really fits with your skills. So number four is to progress fast. This links back to what I said at the start about how you will probably be doing a reasonably bad job because you're just starting out. So just try and do it quickly. There's this thing in business called MVP, which is minimum viable product. And it basically means maybe you want to sell an ebook. You could spend 10 years writing an ebook. You could make it perfect. You could custom design a font that you've written in calligraphy and then scanned in to electronicize it. You could spend an infinite amount of time on writing that ebook. And similarly, you could write an ebook in one day where you just bash it out. It's got loads of typos. The photos are all just off of Google Images, just the top result for everything. So there's essentially an infinite amount of fast or slow that you could do something. You could do an ebook in a day, or you could do an ebook in 10 years. And what I find is that especially beginners, but I think also humans, spend way too long on especially their first one. So if you're doing an ebook, probably don't do it in a day with typos in, but maybe do it in a week and just make the ebook as fast as you can and release it and start selling it. And probably in 6 months, you'll be like, oh gosh, I actually have way more things that I want to add to it, or I've learned more about design. So by all means, remake it. And then because it's electronic, you just take it down from your website, put up the new one. If you really want to, you can contact everyone who's already bought it and be like, good news, there's a version two and it's free. Try to remember that you can always improve it later, but Every week that that ebook is not out and people can't buy it, you're missing out on money. People are coming to your website, they're watching your YouTube channel, they're going to your blog, and they're not spending money because your ebook is still sat on your computer and you're still like faffing around with finding the perfect title font. So try and really push down the perfectionist. Make an ebook a week for 2 months and get 8 ebooks out in a couple of months and just see which one sells. And probably you'll be like, oh my gosh, I never thought the ebook about vegan cookery would sell so well. I'm gonna make more like that. So just progress as fast as you can. And this is for sure the biggest mistake that I see beginners making, is they spend way, way, way too long like thinking, preparing, perfecting. You have to just make stuff and you'll learn as you go. Number 5 is a quick one, and that is move to a hotspot. Go on Nomadlist or go on some of my previous videos where I've said locations that are really popular, and just move to a popular location as soon as you can, and then get really plugged into the community, because going to a hotspot will mean that you learn so much. We started off in Chiang Mai, which is kind of like the most popular place to go. And we met so many interesting people and it made it so much more real. And possibly while you're in your home country, people are saying like, what is being a nomad? It doesn't sound like this will work. It sounds like it's a scam. It sounds like it's impossible. It sounds like maybe it's not right for you. And you'll be surrounded by people who don't understand and who've never seen it. And when you actually go to Canggu in Bali or Medellin in Colombia and you meet people who are doing it, hundreds of them, you're just like, oh my gosh, I can do this. This is so easy. As soon as you can, just move to a nomad hotspot and get totally plugged into the community. It will make things so much easier for you. Number 6 links onto that, and that is to get connected to other nomads. Once you're in the hotspot, don't just live in your hotel room or in your co-work, like go and speak to people, speak to as many people as you can, and just get involved in the community. Ask them what their job is like, ask them if they enjoy it, ask them the mistakes they've made, ask them the advice they have. Everyone will be so happy to help. Listen to podcasts, watch YouTube videos, subscribe to mine while you're here, and just learn from other people. The thing that I would say though is people quite often message me asking for advice, and I help when I can, but it's so much more valuable, I think, to meet someone in real life, you know, become their friend and bounce ideas off each other. I think people quite often don't appreciate how busy people are, and especially if you have a public profile like me, then a lot of people message me, and I don't mind if you message asking, like, do you prefer Bali or Thailand, something specific. But if you just message me being like, how do I get started, please help, then it kind of shows a lack of respect for that person's time. So this is not just about me personally, but influencers in general or people who are successful. The best way to access successful people is to go and find them in real life and hang out. And there's loads of other people who are really successful who don't have an online profile. So go to Chiang Mai and you will meet tons of amazing people, and then it's much more of like a two-way exchange, so you're friends and you're helping each other. So yeah, get plugged in with the community, because that's for sure the best way to progress. And then lastly, number 7 is to take the first small step, ideally today. Try not to wait until you're like, next year we're going to move to Thailand and we're saving up all our money and that's what we're going to do, and when we move we will become nomads. Don't have that like big future scary launch date where you get on a plane and there's no turning back and it's kind of this like huge scary thing. Just start today. Just like sign up for Upwork. You don't even have to make the profile. Just start following some more people on Instagram or subscribe to a few more YouTube channels and just start making steps towards it. They can be small, but that's the way that you're going to progress, is just small steps. And then when you look backwards, you'll be like, oh my gosh, I've come such a long way. There really is no time like today. I really encourage you to start making progress. Follow some of these tips and just make your first little leap. Just message an old client and see if they'll hire you for some freelance work. You can do it in the weekends. Okay, the sun is coming out now and it's gonna ruin my shot, so I'm gonna leave you guys to go. But I hope that these tips were useful to you. I hope that you are excited about becoming a nomad. It's totally possible for you, and I'm sure you're gonna have an amazing time. So thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.